Hello everybody, B. Squirkelhausen here, Jay from Upside Up Productions, and with me I have a review of a rather old set. This set came out in 2010, and it is of course the 7937 Train Station. This set comes with 361 pieces, 4 minifigures, and sells for $50 here in the US. The box says it's marked as a limited edition, but judging by the fact that it's been out for so long, and the fact that you can still buy it even now, I'm not really sure how limited that edition is. Anyway, this set is rumored to be being discontinued for 2014, so I figured why not get it now and give it a quick review before it reaches the end of the line. Let's quickly go in and take a look at the minifigures. And here are the 4 minifigures. You've got the taxi driver, 2 travelers, and the station manager. The taxi driver here could of course be just the third traveler, but there's a taxi cab in the set and he's kind of portrayed to be the driver on the box, so he gets to be the cab driver. He's far more dressed up than any of the cab drivers I know. That right there is a female minifigure, and you will notice that she has a male face, and it's in fact the new style of kind of the plain eyebrowed face, which kind of, it's interesting because it means that the set that I got is actually relatively new in production, rather than just being an old leftover. So that means the set is still in production and probably will be, at least part of the way into 2014. Right here, you'll notice the station manager with a really nice train-specific kind of suit jacket torso. He makes a very good conductor for a passenger train if you don't have one already. He, of course, has his little conductor's wand and black hat and black pants, looking very dressed up for his job. These minifigures are all pretty good. They've all kind of used prints, though. I mean, the only one that even has a back print is the female traveler. And I mean, they're all kind of old prints. Makes sense because it's an old set, but nothing super special, and really, you'll probably, if you're decent, have a decent city collection, you'll probably have most of these torsos and most of these minifigures pretty much already. As for accessories and things, I mean, the taxi driver doesn't have anything, but you can kind of assume that maybe one of the suitcases the female traveler has are his. He, of course, also has the taxi. You saw it in the back, in the rear shot, but the male traveler has a backpack, and of course the station manager has his little wand. Now let's take a closer look at the big accessory in this set, the taxi cab. And here it is. It's a pretty normal city vehicle, you can see. It's a bit strange, kind of blocky, no doors, but I mean, it looks nice. Lots of little fiddly stickers all around it, and if you start turning it around, you'll be able to see it in more detail. But you definitely get a taxi feel, and it's weird that we'd only see one taxi in such a long time of city, and that would come in a train station set. Around the front, you can see it's just got a license plate there, other sides nearly identical. No car doors in this set, that's kind of okay, just because it's old. You can see that big blocky back that's a bit strange. Now this set was one of the first ones that were able to hold 2 people, this taxi cab, and it can do that and have a little bit of luggage room as well. If we take a look at the interior here, you're going to be able to see that the taxi driver's got his own little blue chair and seat, and the passenger just has to kind of sit on the floor. Of course, you can see the luggage room right here in the back, and that's about it for the cab. On to the nice train station itself. And here is the train station itself. Now, you'll notice, first thing, you got 4 pieces of track, and you get this really cool 2-platform design with a bridge here and just a small little shop like that. Now, this is actually pretty unique and very different to the other LEGO City train stations that we've seen so far, which are more like a building on one platform. And it's actually really nice and gives a nice bit of depth to the entire set as a whole. And of course, everybody likes things going underneath other things in movies and animations and things like that. So you get a lot of details like that. A ticket machine here. I've just put this little 1x1 white tile in. It's a spare piece. I've just put it in there as a ticket. It would have been really nice to get actually like a printed up ticket piece for the ticket machine, but I mean, again, it's an extra. Wouldn't have really needed it. It still looks just as good. Right here you can see this little signage area. There's a little trash can, a light, and of course the rail map. And even though this looks like a smaller kind of suburban train station, the train actually goes to a lot of different places. I read them real quick. It's like Berlin, Moscow, Madrid, all sorts of places all over Europe and Asia. And of course, this being LEGO, the train does stop. If it comes back into focus, you can see right below London, Billund, which is, of course, LEGO's headquarters. I mean, that map really doesn't mean much to the fact that the trains go all over mainland Europe. It does not, and even to Asia. That map does not really line up with the real destinations, but it's actually a map that LEGO's used before. I've got a few old train stations, and they all come with another little map piece. You can see, I'm just going to bring it up to the camera right now. Here it is. Don't really know if you're going to be able to see that, but it's the same map, and just with a few tiny little differences. Grab it again. And I mean, you can see there's like little bits of construction, I guess, that they've changed. But, and of course, the color substitution, blue to yellow. But, I mean, it's really cool that they've kept this map. LEGO's definitely a big fan of having these long, continuing logos and icons and things. I mean, you can see that just because of the train logo that's all over. This has been with LEGO trains for ages now. So anyway, that's the map. We're going to move on to the next bit, is the little shop here. It's pretty small, just need to lower the camera a little bit. And very simple inside. It's just made up of big wall panels, and you've got your little computer checkout area and the shop with just like six sodas. Over here on the side of this set, you can see its age, the new truck in town, which of course is the old LEGO truck, which is now not even made anymore, and it's being advertised as new. Then of course, the little headline that I really like, great news, and then a random graph. I really wish that I could see great news just kind of randomly put up as a headline in more place. It's just kind of comedically generic. Anyway, moving on around the other parts of the building, you can see that they've got the nice analog clock as well as a sign up here. The city sign is just the regular train logo covered up by city. This sliding door with the little sticker on it, it's really cool, definitely good for animations, and it's very unique to this set. I'm surprised they haven't used sliding doors like this in more sets. Apart from that, I mean, it's just a little cool thing to add. You've got the clock here, I think I already mentioned that, and then the loudspeaker, which of course you need to announce when a train comes. Two little flower pots, add a little bit of decoration and finish off the design. Of course, you got one of the many street light things around the set that would light up the platform. Two little blue seats right there are the only seating at this train station, so you better hope you get there early for your train, or you're going to have to stand. Now, this cool bridge structure is really neat, and it's definitely really cool. I like the fact that they put railings on. LEGO's not usually famous for putting railings on their things. Just minifigures need to watch out. One little problem is the height. So I grabbed my tallest passenger train. This is the Horizon Express from earlier this year, and you can see it fits under no problem. So, I mean, passenger trains, you should be absolutely fine on. And it looks really good. I mean, it adds a nice bit of depth around, good distance from the platform. But now freight trains, you'll notice that those might sometimes be taller. So I've got this. It's a car from the Maersk train in full, like, double stack mode. Here it is. You see that, toss it onto the tracks here. These are custom containers, but they're the same dimension. And you see it doesn't quite fit. Just a couple of plates too short. I'll probably add a couple just to make sure. But I mean, if you're the kind of person who has the Maersk train yourself, chances are pretty good that you're also gonna have a bunch of switch tracks and things. It's not really a set that you buy just as your first train or anything. So hopefully you'll be able to just kind of switch that freight train around. Otherwise, you can have an interesting little sequence in film or whatever if you just have that smashing off. But I mean, it's easy enough, and it's only in double stack. You always just put a little track around it like that. That'd actually look better too, because you get to use both sides of a platform. So, I mean, apart from that, I don't think many people would have that Maersk train or any extra tall train that would cause problems. And, I mean, other than that, it fits all passenger trains, really, and those are what need to be going through this train station, I guess. It's weird that you'd be unloading freight right here. So now you come to a bit of a thing. And that's this, the old train station set. This is the 7997 train station, which came from 2007, 387 pieces and 5 minifigures. Mine's a bit customized. You can see like a pair of Johnny Thunders in there and some figures that didn't come with it, a little bit of modernization and modification, but I mean, it still shows it. This set came with more pieces and was cheaper, which is a sign of the times, I guess, but I really like both, actually. I mean, this train station, the old one, looks very good, and the new one, of course, looks very good as well, and they both look like they can belong to the same system. They're different colors, they're different shapes, they're different just types of train station. So, I mean, they can both get along, I guess, and just end up looking really cool. You could also put them end-to-end, which I've tried, and the platform color is different, of course, which makes it, it's kind of a shame, but, like, you can, it still works. Of course, the old one's got a more detailed interior. I've added stuff to this, like the office up top. That's my custom thing. But, I mean, it still really works with the old set and the new set, and they combine. I do like the old set's accessory, that little hand cart, rather than the taxi cab. But, I mean, I'm happy that we got a taxi cab, so it can't be that bad. Anyway, that's about it. Time to get rid of this old set and go sum up my opinions. So really, now that I have this set, I'm a little bit bummed that I waited such a long time to actually go and buy it. It's really nice. I actually really like it. You get a good number of figures. It's a little bit strange because you need maybe one more, like a train station worker who's not the station manager or the train conductor or whatever, to work in that little shop. But I mean, apart from that, it's really good. I love getting a taxi cab finally, and even though it's kind of blocky and old, it looks nice still and definitely fits in with the rest of the city vehicles. If you have a decent train collection, I highly recommend picking this up. If you don't though, it's not really that smart unless you want to spend 50 bucks on just the taxi cab. Anyway, that's about it. Thanks for watching, check out my other reviews, and I will see you next time.